Hi there, my name's Carrie, and today I will take you through the steps of programming a virtual rain timer. I hate these timers. There's multiple steps you have to take in each stage of the programming. There's this little bloody cursor that flashes that you have to follow when you're programming the timer, and if there's dim or poor lighting, it's almost impossible to see. So if you're in the market for a new timer, this is definitely not the one to buy. Anyway, let's try and muddle through the programming of this thing. The first step is to turn the dial to the date and time. And as you can see, if I push the minus arrow or the plus arrow, then I can adjust the time of day. Next step is to set the current year, and so I press enter. Notice that the cursor is flashing next to the triangle by year. I use the up and down arrows to get the current year. Press enter. The cursor goes to the current month. I use the up and down arrows to set the current month. Once the current month is correct, I press enter again and I enter the current day. Once I get the current day entered correctly, I press enter one last time to finish this part of the program. The next step will be to turn the dial to the blue area where program A is showing and begin entering the start times. And if you look up in the upper left of the display, our little cursor is flashing next to a little triangle, and that means that we are now inputting the start time, the first start time on program A. Once I get the start time that I want, I will push enter to enter that start time, and if I want to add more start times, I will push the next button and enter the start times in the same sequence that I did the first start time. Next, I will turn the dial to the station run times. And if you'll notice at the bottom of the display, right above the station one that's written on the timer, the cursor is flashing below the little triangles. So after you get the time entered that you want for each station, by using the plus and minus arrows, you push the enter button, and as you see, the cursor will flash underneath the next station. Repeat these steps for stations 4 through 6, and then turn the dial to water days, and we will begin inputting into the timer which days we want to water. Notice at the top of the display that the cursor is flashing below the triangles on the days of the week, and if a triangle is visible, that means that that day will water. When I advance the cursor to the interval odd and even day watering, I will push the next button so that I don't enter those functions into the timer. If I want to set a day of the week not to water, I will press the enter button until the cursor's flashing under that day, and then I will press the clear button to shut that day off. And now I have Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday set to water on this timer. Next is manually watering, and what I've done is pushed manual, next, and next until you can see just the A showing in the display, and then I press enter to start program A watering through a manual cycle. If I want to go from station 1 to station 2, then I press the next button. And you can see that the triangle is flashing over station 2. And you use this same process to advance through all of the stations on the sprinkler system. So that's it for this video on programming a virtual rain timer. If you would like more information on timers that I recommend, then please visit my blog at iscaper.com. Thanks for watching.